frequently asked questions about diagnosis and evaluation of heart failure. What is heart failure? Heart failure is a complex clinical syndrome that can result from any structural or functional cardiac disorder that impairs the ability of the ventricle to fill with or reject blood. How is heart failure diagnosed? There is no single diagnostic test for heart failure. Therefore, it remains a clinical diagnosis requiring a history, physical examination, and laboratory testing. Symptoms of heart failure can be caused by systolic or diastolic dysfunction. What are the types of heart failure? In systolic heart failure, cardiac output is decreased directly through reduced left ventricular function. In diastolic heart failure, cardiac output is compromised by poor ventricular compliance, impaired relaxation, and worsened end diastolic pressure. As many as 40 to 50% of patients with heart failure have diastolic heart failure with preserved left ventricular function. What are the other differences between systolic and diastolic heart failure? Patients with diastolic heart failure are more likely to be women, to be older, and to have hypertension, atrial fibrillation, and left ventricular hypertrophy, but no history of CAD compared with systolic heart failure, which has well-validated therapies. Diastolic heart failure lacks evidence-based treatment recommendations. What are the common causes of heart failure? The common causes are coronary artery disease, hypertension, idiopathic cardiomyopathy, and valvular heart disease. How is severity of heart failure gauged? The New York Heart Association classification system is the simplest and most widely used method to gauge symptom severity. The classification system is a well-established predictor of mortality and can be used at diagnosis and to monitor treatment response. Class 1. No limitations of physical activity. No heart failure symptoms. Class 2. Mild limitation of physical activity. Heart failure symptoms with significant exertion, comfortable at rest or with mild activity. Class 3. Marked limitation of physical activity. Heart failure symptoms with mild exertion, only comfortable at rest. Class 4. Discomfort with any activity. Heart failure symptoms occur at rest. What is the AIM of the initial clinical evaluation? Although no single item on clinical history, sign, or symptom has been proven to be diagnostic, many are helpful in assessing the probability of heart failure. The initial clinical evaluation, detailed, is directed at confirming heart failure, determining potential causes, and identifying comorbid illnesses. Evaluation for ischemic heart disease is warranted in patients with heart failure, especially if angina is present, given that CAD is the most common cause of heart failure. What are the symptoms of heart failure? Patients with heart failure can have decreased exercise tolerance with dyspnea, fatigue, generalized weakness, and fluid retention, with peripheral or abdominal swelling and possibly orthopnea. What are the findings in the physical examination? The presence of a third heart sound or ventricular filling gallop is an indication of increased left ventricular end diastolic pressure and a decreased LVEF. Despite being relatively uncommon findings, a third heart sound and displaced cardiac apex are good predictors of left ventricular dysfunction and effectively rule in the diagnosis of systolic heart failure. The presence of jugular venous distension, hepatojugular reflux, pulmonary rails, and pitting peripheral edema is indicative of volume overload and enhances the probability of a heart failure diagnosis. What are BNP and what is it used for? BNP is secreted by the atria and ventricles in response to stretching or increased wall tension. As BNP levels increase, the specificity increases and thus the likelihood of a heart failure diagnosis. What is the chest radiography used for? Chest radiography findings of venous congestion or interstitial edema are useful in identifying heart failure. What is the ECG used for? Electrocardiography is useful for identifying other causes in patients with suspected heart failure. Changes such as left bundle branch block, left ventricular hypertrophy, acute or previous myocardial infarction, or atrial fibrillation can be identified and may warrant further investigation by echocardiography, stress testing, or cardiology consultation. Which is the most common criteria used for the diagnosis of heart failure? The Framingham criteria are widely accepted and include the components of the initial evaluation, which enhances their accuracy. Heart failure is diagnosed when two major criteria or one major and two minor criteria are met. What is echocardiography used for? Echocardiography is the most widely accepted and available method for identifying systolic dysfunction and should be performed after the initial evaluation to confirm the presence of heart failure. Two-dimensional echocardiography with Doppler flow studies can assess LVEF, left ventricular size, wall thickness, valve function, and the pericardium. Echocardiography can assist in diagnosing diastolic heart failure if elevated left atrial pressure, impaired left ventricular relaxation, and decreased compliance are present. How is systolic heart failure ruled out? If the Framingham criteria are not met, or if the BNP level is normal, systolic heart failure is essentially ruled out. When should echocardiography be performed? Echocardiography should be performed to assess LVEF when heart failure is suspected or if diastolic heart failure is still suspected when systolic heart failure is ruled out. What are the treatment options guided by? Treatment options are guided by the final diagnosis of either systolic or diastolic heart failure and echocardiography results, with a consideration to evaluate for CAD.
Audio Jungle. Audio Jungle.